when South Africa was reintroduced to the global economy in 1994, then the government intentionally came up with strategies on how they could be integrated into the global economy, and also how they could participate meaningfully into the global trade. Hence, one of the strategies then that was popular was the so-called export processing zones. And countries like, for instance, Singapore, Taiwan, etc., experience a lot of economic growth and trade through export processing zones. So South Africa came up with this concept of industrial development zone, which is similar to export processing zones. And then the main goal was to sort of manufacture for and export immediately. Hence, the industrial development zone as a concept was were designated near the seaport or international airport for ease of logistics. But then, as the time progressed, where there were lots of policy developments in the country, and there was national development plan and national policy action plan, those policies and strategies were not there when the industrial development zone was introduced. So there was a need, a necessity to synchronize sort of the instrument, because an industrial development zone is an instrument, a policy instrument. So the government needed a tool that would be versatile and sort of address all the development needs of the country. Because we find that in the definition and criteria of IDZ, it was sort of restraining some areas of the country that are well resourced but are not near the seaport or international airport. So then the government came up with this generic broad concept called special economic zone.